It's by far the hardest thing I've ever done. To be so.
It was John Denver, Follow Me, Where I Go, What I Do, Who I Know. I still think that's an important song. Make it part of you to be a part of me. That's what life is like. You know, when you get married, you follow each other in a sense. You know, if there's something I really want to do and include Dad, he'll do it. And if there's something he wants to do, like go to something or funerals that we go to or weddings or whatever, that, you know, we follow each other in a sense. I met Robert, let me think. His sister married my stepfather. So the first time I actually saw him was at their wedding. And I had on platform heels, were popular then. So I had on platform shoes. I remember a long velvet patchwork skirt. I felt beautiful, and I looked, and Bob is a little bit shorter than me, half an inch. Well, I looked down, my platform shoes made him about 4 inches shorter than me. So I looked down, I saw him, and I crossed him off my list. I was 26 at the time, 25, 26. Crossed him off my list because he was much too short. I was living and working in Chicago at the time. I was teaching, and he sent me a letter, a formally typed letter on legal stationery. And I was kind of impressed, you know, about wanting to get together and being willing to come to Chicago and stuff like that. And I was really happy to get the letter, but I waited 3 weeks to respond, to write him back. This was days before technology. Phone calls were expensive, and you did snail mail.
We made arrangements to meet in Chicago. I flew to Chicago. I went to Des Moines when I was going to an Iowa U football game. So instead of going to Iowa City, I went to Des Moines and got on a flight to Chicago, and she met me at the airport.
He got off the plane. I wasn't there. He said he almost turned around. He was so shy. I mean, Robert just really is shy, and so he was shy, and then finally I saw him, and then I lived near Lake Michigan, and that was always a special treat, and we walked around the lake, and actually, I think it was on the phone, he said, the shy Robert, he said, if I have a question, do you have an answer? And I said, yes, and then he said, will you marry me? And I said, yes, and he was kind and gentle, and he had a good job. You know, I thought it was cool that he was a lawyer, and I was willing to move away from Chicago.
June 22nd, 1970.
We were married in 1974 on the longest day of the year. We held it at St. Teresa's Church because we liked the priest, Father Leek. We didn't know about the tuxes, and my photographer brother Greg assured me that 10 years from now, no one's going to know what colors you wear, so don't worry about it. We had yellow dresses, bridesmaids' dresses with little white flowers. I forget what that material is called. And then the groomsmen wore brown. It's a different kind of comfortable around each other. Bob is very predictable, and I'm sure I'm predictable to him. He's predictable, you know, I know he's gonna take his time getting dressed, and I know that it takes him a while to get things done, and I can predict. It's funny, when we're, Bob is 76 and I'm 67, and it is really funny when he'll say, should I wear this sweater? Or when I say, I'll come to him and I'll hold up two necklaces and I'll say, which one looks good with this sweater? It's kind of cute when we're still asking each other what we should wear.
I would have to say that we've got four distinct personalities, that hardly one is, there may be so much alike, but in so many areas they're so completely different in the way they look, the way they talk. There's, we've got a not a Heinz variety, but we got a pretty good variety of four children that we've loved and enjoyed watching them mature into adults. But we went through all that in 40 years, and it was until I retired almost like a snap of the finger.
Come fill me up.